Welcome to a lesson on range and standard deviation. In this lesson, we'll define range, define standard deviation, and also find the range and standard deviation of a set of data. The range is the difference between the maximum value and the minimum value of the data set. So here we have a data set that gives us the average gas mileage of 10 vehicles. First, notice how the data is ordered from least to greatest, which makes it easier to identify the maximum value and minimum value. Notice the maximum value is 38 and the minimum value is 12. And therefore, if we want to find the range will be the difference between these values. So the range is equal to 38 minus 12, giving a range of 26. Now let's talk about standard deviation. The standard deviation is a measure of variation based on measuring how far each data value deviates or is different from the mean. And here are a few important characteristics about standard deviation. Standard deviation is always positive. Standard deviation will be zero if all the data values are equal and will get larger as the data spreads out. Standard deviation has the same units as the original data. And standard deviation, like the mean, can be highly influenced by outliers, or values that are very large or very small compared to the rest of the data. Before we discuss how to find the standard deviation, let's review how to find the mean of a data set. The mean of a set of data is the sum of the data values divided by the number of values. Remember, mean is the same as the average. So if we want to find the mean of the data set from the previous slide, which is the gas mileage of 10 vehicles, we would find the sum and then divide by 10 because there are 10 data values. Notice here, the mean or average indicated by x bar is equal to 23, and this would be 23 miles per gallon. And here's how we find the standard deviation. Step one, we find the deviation of each data value from the mean. In other words, we subtract the mean from each data value. We indicate this by x sub n minus x bar, where x sub n would be one of the data values and x bar is the mean. Step two, we square the deviation, or square the differences. Step three, we add the squared deviations. Step four, we divide by n the number of data values if the data represents a whole population. And we divide by n minus 1 if the data is from a sample. And then finally, step 5, we compute the square root of the result. And here's the formula for standard deviation. Notice how here we're dividing by n minus 1, so this would be the formula for a sample. If this was just n, it would be the formula for a population. So again, looking at the numerator, notice how we first find the difference of each data value in the mean. Then we square each difference, then we find the sum, then we divide by either n or n minus 1, and then finally take the square root. So if we want to find the standard deviation of our data set, again, the first step is to find the mean, which we already did, which is equal to 23. Now this problem does not indicate whether this is a sample or a population, so we'll actually find both standard deviations, where this letter here is called sigma. So sigma sub s would be the sample standard deviation, and sigma sub p would be the population standard deviation. To keep this nice and neat, I think it is important to organize the information in a table like I've done here. Notice how I listed the data values here in the first column. The second column takes each data value and subtracts the mean, which would be x sub n minus x bar. So 12 minus 23, 14 minus 23, and so on. So again, this is the first step where we find the difference of the data value in the mean. Next, we square these values, which we see here in the third column. And for the next step, we're going to sum all these values, which would give us the numerator here underneath the square root. So notice the sum of the deviation squared is equal to 550, which again would be this value here under the square root. And then because we have 10 data values n is equal to 10. So notice for the sample standard deviation, n minus 1 would be 9. And for the population standard deviation, we just divide by n, which is 10. So the sample standard deviation would be the square root of 550 divided by 9, which is approximately 7.8. The value before we take the square root is called the sample variance. And for the population standard deviation, 550 divided by 10, or 55, would be the population variance. So notice how the population standard deviation is approximately 7.4, and the sample standard deviation is approximately 7.8. And again, the units on these would be miles per gallon, the same as the units on the original data. Now let's finish by talking about interpreting the standard deviation. The standard deviation, represented by the Greek letter sigma, shows how much variation from the average or mean exists. A low standard deviation indicates that the data values tend to be very close to the mean. A high standard deviation indicates that the data points are spread out over a large range of values. The standard deviation is also helpful when comparing two sets of related data. Consider the rating of two auto repair centers. Company A and Company B have mean ratings of 3.0 stars, but Company A's ratings have a standard deviation of 0.5, and Company B's ratings have a standard deviation of 1.5. So the question is, what does this tell us? Well, it tells us that Company B's ratings are more spread out from the mean rating of 3 stars than Company A's ratings. Company A's ratings has a smaller standard deviation, so more of the ratings are close to the mean of 3 stars, which means for Company B, more people gave higher ratings and lower ratings than 3 stars, and more of Company A ratings were close to the average of 3 stars. I hope you found this lesson helpful.